was one of the most enjoyable. This was one of the sneakiest patients I ever saw. 55-year-old guy, chief complaint was, I'm weak. Toned out the ambulance. And anybody who comes in the ER, I'm always eyeballing. Like, I always want to know what's going on in the ER. I take high degree of responsibility for the ER I'm in. So the ambulance comes in. The EMS brings this guy in with weakness. And I remember when he rolled in, he looked at me like this. He went, and he waved to me as he's brought into a room. And right away, I'm upset with this guy. I'm thinking, this guy is abusing the system. So I go in the room, sir, what's going on? My name's John. I'm the physician assistant. What's going on? He says, I'm weak. I said, okay. What do you mean you're weak? He says, I can't get off the couch. So what do you mean you can't get off the couch? I'm just weak. I can't get off the couch. I says, well, how do you pee? Sir, how do you pee? I'm like, I got him, huh? He says, well, I've had to pee in a bottle. So what do you mean you have to pee in a bottle? He says, well, every time I take a step, I get short of breath. Okay, you got my attention. Fine. You do a 12 lead. Let's start a cardiac workup. CBC, comp, coags, cardiac enzymes. Remember in the ringer. Some other tests I could order. EKGs. Watching out. So I get this EKG back. They bring me in the EKG, and I'm looking at it, and I'm going, the heck is that? Is that? Wait a second. Is that elevation? Is that two up and two down? So wait. This can't be a heart attack. Sir, have you had chest pain? No. Have you had indigestion? No. Have you had shortness of breath? No. Jaw pain? No. Chest? Have you had any kind of pains? Nothing. So I come back out and go, is this really ST segment elevation? Is this a STEMI? That doesn't make sense. He's had no symptoms. Wait. How would his heart rate be if he's really having an inferior wall MI? I mean, would it be 45? Yeah, this is kind of consistent. Let's take a closer look at this. If I draw my line, wait, there's ST segment elevation here. This is, looks like a STEMI. And wait, he's got this big fat Q wave that says he's got a transmural infarction that's got to be going on for a while. So I go back in, like, what would explain a silent MI in a 55-year-old? He said, sir, when's the last time you saw a doc? He said, I haven't seen a doc in like 10 years. So what patients were put on this earth to burn us? Diabetic. So I said, go check a finger stick on this guy. So they checked the finger stick, and it came back at 3:30. So when I started doing the labs, I'm like, this is a silent MI in an untreated diabetic. He presented with weakness. Here was cardiac enzymes. What can you infer from these cardiac enzymes about the timing of his MI? Like, what can you logically say, understanding the ringer? What I can say is, whatever happened, it's already occurred. It's not still going on because the myoglobin's normal, and he's got to be at least 6-8 hours out because his myoglobin's normal. Does that make sense to you? We don't know what's happened with the troponin yet. Is it on the way up, on the way down? Don't know, but he's outside this window, and again, CKs, they don't give me any clinical information. So this is just telling me he's outside of about an 8-hour window.